Welcome to CGTN live stream. I'm reporter Cui Huiyao. We are at this amazing Xinjiang series. This is our 11th day of coverage, and right now in Yining, the capital of Ili Kazakh Autonomous Prefecture. And today I'm going to introduce you to China's perhaps the most famous living writer, Wang Meng. He is 86 years old and he has written over 100 novels, and he was awarded China's top literature award and also taken a number of posts, including the Minister of China's Cultural Ministry, as well as a number of the principal of numerous cultural institutions. He was also the head of literature college of several universities across China. So he's a very famous person. Now, you might wonder why we talk about him in Xinjiang. Well, he spent 16 years of his life in Xinjiang, and 6 years of which are spent in Ili Kazakh Autonomous Prefecture. And where I'm right now at is Wang Meng Shu, translated as Wang Meng Library. Here, it reconstructed the scenes of his work and life in Xinjiang, and particularly in this Bayandai County. So we are entering this public commune, a very interesting concept during the Maoist era. And so you might wonder, how come a writer spent that many years in the western part of China? Well, he started writing in his 20s, and very soon he became well known in the literature circle. In 1986, he published a novel in which he made a critique of the bureaucracy in socialist China, and that book caught the attention of Chairman Mao. And just before the Cultural Revolution, he was banished as And in 1963, he was sent to Xinjiang to be reformed through labor. What you're seeing right now are some of the farming tools he used during that period of time. Now, it was a time of hard time spent with local weavers, become the material for some of his best short stories and novels. First arrived in Xinjiang, he was an editor. He was an editor for a magazine in Urumqi, the capital of Xinjiang, Uyghur Autonomous Region, and later became the vice captain of this public commune we just saw. What you're seeing right now is a tractor. I assume that was also one of those many farming tools he and his colleagues had used during his time in Xinjiang. Now, if you look at his autobiography, it is a really colorful record of life. He lived through a very eventful era. We all know that during the Cultural Revolutions, a lot of intellectuals were denounced and banished, and they were sent to various parts of China to be reformed through labor. So that's why we called it a period of political turmoil. And when that was all over, he returned back to Beijing. That is where he was originally born. He was born in Beijing. Now we are entering another part of Wang Meng Shu, Wang Meng Library. This is his museum, basically. Here are some of the years we saw. 1978, that was after the Cultural Revolution, he returned back to where he was originally from. Now, we were saying that during that period of hardship, he was banished as a rightist, and he lived with a lot of locals and farmers, but he remained optimistic. He was a very upbeat person. He learned Uyghur, which was rare for a Han person. He really had a great time with locals in Xinjiang, and that won him the affection, the great affection among locals. So when this museum and library was established, he was welcomed. It was warmly welcomed by a lot of people here. Now, why he loved the Xinjiang so much? Now, his heart was captured by the natural magnificence and panorama of multi-ethnic culture. By the way, what you're seeing right now is the office, or some of the stationaries like books and tables he used during that period. So he was captured. His heart was taken away by the natural sceneries in Xinjiang. We all know Xinjiang is known not just for its local cuisine like da panji or lamb or beef, but also like snow-capped mountains, shades of grain, and a variety of grasslands and sceneries and lakes and mountains. It was just beautiful. His heart was taken away. But it was not just that. He also relished, he was charmed by the way people live. I especially like this paragraph in which the author wrote, Xinjiang suited Wang. He marveled at the region's beauty, the towering populous lakes that seemed as blue as the sky. He was charmed by the Uyghurs' approach to life, by the way peasant families grew roses even when they didn't have enough to eat. He relished the flatbread and lamb that dominated local cuisine and was moved by the melancholy Uyghur sauce. Now, this was him and his wife, Cui Ruifang, in Ili, Kazakh Autonomous Prefecture. The picture was taken in Guozigo, which is a place right near Yining, about an hour away from Yining. So this museum showcased a lot of his photographs, manuscripts, and it was a great place to see this deep bond he has created, he has established with locals there. Now, for those who just tune in to our live stream, I'm reporter Cui Huiao. We are in Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region. We're celebrating the 65th anniversary of the establishment of this region. And my team is doing a 30-day tour throughout Xinjiang from the north to the west and from mid Xinjiang to the south. Now, we are in this amazing Wangmen Library. Here it documents some of his time. We are taking you through his life journey in Xinjiang. And we are about to exit the museum, but before we exit, we can show more of his photos. That was his father, Wang Jingdi. That was Wangmen's mother and his siblings. You know, in his last novel, View of This Side, which is set in Xinjiang, he won China's top award for literature, Mao Dun Award. That award is given every 4 years. The novel starts with a bizarre theft of grain, and the plot moves on as the mysterious theft is solved layer by layer. It offers a unique view of the culture and customs of Western China. And he wrote in the postscript to the novel that what can live long is not political labels, power symbols, historical climaxes. It is the details, the people, the love and trust, and it's the narration and the world. So you can see that his novels has a very strong local flavor and is very touching in many ways for people who grew up in this land, because this is the unfamiliar West for a lot of people who have never been to Xinjiang or to the western part of China. And what you see right here is the sculpture of Wang Meng. He is 86 years old and he still appears on a lot of talk shows. I personally follow him, like he appears on CCTV, he appears on Phoenix TV, and he's a very well-read person, and he called on the young generation like myself to read more, to read the difficult books, and to get a sense of what life is about. That's what's powerful about literature. Now, I'm gonna wrap it up here. We're gonna toss to my colleague Li Zhao. He's at a house nearby, and he's gonna speak to someone who actually knows and interacted with Wang Meng, the famous writer, and tell us what his life journey was like during his period in Xinjiang. That's all from me.
All right, guys. So my colleague Huiyao has just told you about Wang Meng's years here in Xinjiang by historical records. He also showed you some of his old photos during his time here in Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region. Guys, that was in 1960s, a period of time when Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region was not as developed as it is today. So Wang Meng was like everyone else here. He did a lot of farm work. And today, the guest we're introducing today is one of his colleagues. They did a lot of farm work together. And this, let's call him this grandpa. He spent something about 6 years with Wang Meng. And he told me they did farm work together. They collected feces for, you know, to really plant. And he had some great time when Wang Meng taught him the Chinese language, Mandarin, and he taught Wang Meng the Uyghur language. Now, Wang Meng was, of course, one of the time period when And I think Han traveled to places pretty remote here in Xinjiang. We're in Bayandai County. This is not a very large county. A lot of the residents here really, they speak ethnic Uyghur because most of them are ethnic Uyghur. And they speak the Uyghur language and most of them don't know how to speak Mandarin. And now let's go in and come visit this gentleman who has been working alongside author Wang Meng for 6 years. 大爷您好。您好，您好，大爷。跟我们镜头打一个招呼吧。哎，您坐，您坐，跟我们镜头打一个招呼。
你们好。
All right, so this is the gentleman who have been working alongside author Wang Meng, and because he doesn't really speak Mandarin, so we got a translator here for us as well, and she's a local, guide for the Wang Meng Library, where Huiyao just took you guys to. 这是我们的翻译小姐姐，给大家也打一个招呼吧。
大家好。
好，那大爷，咱们就开始。All right, so now we're going to retrack his years with author Wang Meng. 大爷，您能先给我们讲一下王蒙是大概什么时候来到咱们巴彦代镇工作的吗？
巴彦代келген 65-nji ýyl kelgen Wang Meng. 65-nji ýyl kelip 70-nji ýylgacha Ba Yandai kentde işlegen. İşleş jarayanda osy halkly bilen ýetişde, tamakda, yığında, hemme de birik boğan. Biz kentimizde aş adam işlep, biz kentten ki bu terakiyat üçün, milletlerinin itibarlık üçün, biz kentke cik kuş çıkağa adam. Siz söz yapıramsız ya, oldu mu? Aşında, bu adamın ki, bizden azı muş kentte milletle itibarlıkını biz aşıyor. 65 yıldın tatip biz muş milletle itibarlıkını kolak geldiğinden. Çünkü bunu da Wang Meng Efendi'nin ki rolü naiti üstün. De o adam hani bizge aşında muş milletle ara üz ara cidel kınmaslık, üz ara inak üteş, üz ara yardım veriş. Muşun da ahvallarını tola değdiğen. Şu adamın gepleri kulakımızda kalan, biz şu an bizim kendimiz milletle itibarlıkı da birinci desek mi hatalaşmayız. Hamış derecede.
Tamam, bir fayda edin.
Wang Meng 先生是在1965年来到巴彦代，一直到70年。这段时间王猛先生一直是带领我们巴彦代镇，就是民俗团结的一个就是一个模范人物，因为他来到巴彦代以后，他跟所有的就是父老乡亲都达成了一片，不管是在劳动生活，在饭桌上，还是在晚上的休息的时候，他跟所有人都跟亲兄弟姐妹一样的，到现在为止，在我们心里面还是记忆深刻的一个形象。
Okay, so this is a very long paragraph, but let me translate this for you. So Wang Meng arrived here in 1950s. 1960s, and during that time, it was a time period when ethnic Han seldomly do they travel here, but Wang Meng was definitely one of them, and he was here and local and immediately mingle with the locals. He learned the Uyghur language, and this gentleman called him a representative of various ethnic minority groups integration, because he was really a role model, because of his stay and because his learning of the Uyghur language is really push for various ethnic groups really integrate together, and he's set as role model. And this gentleman told us he really spent a lot of time with the locals here. He would eat together with them, he would do labor work with them, do everything with them, and he's trying to really put himself as part of this community. 所以他真的就是把自己当成了这里的一份子，是不是？
Özünü resmi müşahit edemlerle bir kılıp müşahit özünü halkı deyip köygen mi
o? Ha şunda. Zaten o müşahitin halkı ile atabalı dek. Çoğun küçükleri olsa ini sınıl dek. Ak ini dek. Ha şunda inak ötken adam bu. Bu adam kays üyü kırsa dekalını üyüge iş kutukta. Meyli aş üyüde umaç olsun. Meyli kuruk çay olsun. Kan da olsa böyle tamaklandıgan bu adam. Tamak yaydı, kırıp açılın, yoklaydı, kayır çürülünün uyu verip, ağlını sorap, aşında kılıdığan bu adam. Bu adamdan bir yeri yine bir üyde tamak yapkakan bulsa, toyg'ida tamoq yegan bo'lsa, bu odam yenidan ilaqa ochlik millatni chiqirib, endi men ma tamoqni bekor yemay, endi sizlar ma dehqon odam, yo'qsiz, endi ma millatni sizlar xop olmay, bu millatga nima ochlik olsanglar bo'ladi deb boshlab berdigan bu odam. Üzünün aç bildiğini. Manda etkan çağda bu adamın halk boğan köz karşı na yaş boğan. Da? Çünkü halkın işi çünkü şu vakit halkın ki kıyınçılıkını şülüp yetken adamla. Onun deyken bu adamın yanı bir teşvikatı da bizimki dövültümüz muşunda kembalçılık ütmeydi. Bunun yağı muşu dehalarımız baytırmış ki yetişiydi. Dövültümüz kudret de budu, maşin işi de, her kanda işini maşin kurduğun bulumuz, hazır kadar ketmemeli ya, ağdurduğa işler tügeydi, bununla endumuşu. Bütün halık, bizden dövültümüz için istifakımızı yakışılık isek, bizden ronak tapımız, dövültümüz kudret tapı da demişler, terbiye kılıdığan bu adam.
王猛先生一直把自己当作巴彦代的一份子，因为他当时的时候，因为除了工作劳动之余，他就会在所有巴彦代的巷子里面穿梭，然后自己就随意会进入到居民的家里面，然后跟他们一起吃，不管他们吃的简朴还是吃的怎样，他都会融入到他们家庭当中，就跟自己的亲生父母、自己的亲生兄弟姐妹一样。然后他吃完饭以后，会在自己的衣兜里面拿出几张粮票，放到桌子上，说我不能白吃这顿饭，感谢你们教我为王宇，感谢你们款待我。当时他们在一起劳动的时候，王猛先生也非常有远见，一直说我们的日子会越来越好，不管进到。 居民的家里面也好，还是跟他们一起劳动也好，也始终在鼓励他们，说我们会以后会更好，会机械化，我们只要跟大家庭一样的，心连心，我们的日子会越来越好。所以，王猛先生在巴彦代人民心中也是一个很高的一个地位。
大爷，我记得您是不是还有跟王猛的那种合照呀？王猛把那么些跟拉那不那去跟塑料袋包过的吗？能不能拿出来给我们看一看？ Alright, so this gentleman right here is gonna grab some photos for us, but let me explain what he just said. So he said, Wang Meng is definitely one of the role model for the integration of the ethnic minorities. He told me that during his time here, he would eat with the locals because he really wanted to learn the Uyghur language. He knows that although he was not initially part of this community, but he really tries to mingle with the locals. He told us that this gentleman right here told us that he would eat with the locals no matter how poor, maybe they don't eat very nice food, he would still eat with them because he knows that's the best way for him to learn the language, that is really integrate himself with the locals. And what you're seeing right now is definitely some photos during this gentleman's years in Beijing, and he travel to Beijing and meet with Wang Meng. And those are definitely some of the greatest memories.
大爷给我们讲一下照片上这是几几年的事儿啊？好像个好像个瓦克马乌马斯马莱斯蒙特贝德斯拉，好像北京巴干瓦克莫要。是给我们2015年去北京的时候拍下的图片。
This was in 2015 when he was visiting author Wang Meng in Beijing, and as at that time, Wang Meng was already the Minister of Department of Culture.
王猛那时候已经是咱们文化部的部长了，是不是？嗯。去交到门忙的干交的，你像那同事了，不离一天的，王猛不离一天，冲了哟，一个的，没那么远的，去了，不是把是喊你一直，没是王猛的，是孤狼孤狼的。 Aş edemge bir tapşırıp versen diye vezipini vergen bana. Şu vezipini apırıp ben verdim. Onu müşahede.
Belgen
vaktimizde mi şu? Şu Beycin'inki bir nimetle. Biz yığın bağında aşağıda mı şu hattını o adam tapşırıp ben. Tapşırıp da o adam ma hattını ilip közünü sürtüp getirmişim de. Çünkü o adam şu adamın Şincan Golca bayandaydın kegen beni tut kaldırım kepto dep aldığımızı yığılıp çıkan aşağıdan.
15年，他们组织去北京的时候，这儿的村民知道了，这位大爷要去北京，所以他们自己写了一封长长的信，然后把这封信送到大爷家里面，说一定要把这封信，也是我们的思念，带到王蒙先生那里去。然后大爷去北京见到王蒙先生的时候，这张图片就是，他递那封信的时候，
When villagers know that he was gonna meet with author Wang Meng, they wrote author Wang Meng a super long article saying how much they miss him because he's really the role model for here, and a lot of people believe that he really pushed for the development for this place. So they wrote him a very long letter and hoping that he would come back some days.
您是把这封信给王猛送过去了是吧？
见互相见面的时候是什么？对，王猛先生拿到这封信以后就特别感动，然后拿着这封信就一直放到怀里面，一直就贴到脸上面，就表达自己对，就是对巴彦代他们父老乡亲的一个思念。 아니 너막 슬라바간 작도 왕마 밴드 칸다 이시아트 보관.
안 주자다 비즈가 뭐 아담 아시아드 마 레스인데 아시아단 sözüldüden mi? Uygur sözüldü şu vakti bizge. And bu adamın sözlüğünü and Şincan'da, Şincan anda Bayanday'dan kelgeminin tukkalarını kaptı. Ben bu şu restoranken, şu çoğun aşkanıken de bir yerde ben öz yenimden pulunu çıkarıp ben silen bir vakit tamaklıyla meyman kılıvasam de bu adam ben hükümetten pulu emez. Ben üzerimde şahsi aylıkımdım. Bu silenge bir Joz rastladım de bu adam Joz'a bizi teklif kıldı. Şu çağda bu adam bu sözle Uyruş sözlüken bu adam sözle bu şu çağda aşağıda resimli tatlı tıkıyordu. Bu adamın dediğini şu anda közü iş kıyordu.
这张图片是王猛先生他们见到王猛先生是王猛先生当时在跟他们一起讲话的时候，当时王猛先生是用维吾尔语跟他们进行了一个讲话，然后表达就是对他们这么多年的一个思念之情，包括王猛先生亲自邀请他们去一个餐厅，邀请他们吃饭，说你们那么不远万里的过来，然后我一定要从我自己身上掏钱带你们去吃一顿饭，并且叙叙旧。当时他们也是特别感动，所以到现在为止，大爷一说到他15年
Those were the time when they meet in Beijing, and this gentleman right here told us he talked to them in the Uyghur language. So after 40-something years, he still remembers the Uyghur language and remembers the people, of course. And when this gentleman gave him the long letter, he put the letter to his heart because he told them that he will always remember the place, the people, and of course, his friends during his time and during his years here. And that is also a time period when we should really recognize, because people like Wang Meng really push for the development for not just Xinjiang, but also the world and the integration of all kinds of ethnic minorities, really worth the admiration for all people. And that's it for our live stream today. Again, you can always watch us live on our WeChat, our Weibo account, our Instagram, our Twitter, and also our Facebook. And remember to download our official web as well. Thank you so much for watching. And again, I'm Li Zhao. Thank you.